Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are continuing with Operation Common Resolve. I don't know how far we are from the finale, but I think it should be either one or two missions. Like, after this mission that we're going to tackle today, that would be Mission Whistle Stop. Now, the scenario is that terrorist forces have hijacked a munitions train traveling from Turkey into Georgia. Capture this train and stop it before it crosses the border into Georgia. And that's as simple of a premise as you can get. So, yeah, with that being said, I suppose we should go ahead and listen to the mission briefing.
A munitions train traveling through Turkey has been hijacked by Daniil forces. The train has been routed to a spur line and is headed towards a Daniil encampment just over the border. You are ordered to secure the train before it crosses the border. Bravo will be inserted by helicopter onto the already moving train. Once aboard, neutralize all terrorists and prevent the train from stopping at the encampment. Although this is a hijacking, Intel believes there is only a handful of terrorists aboard the train.
Yeah, I can see that Intel might believe that, and it is like a munitions train after all. But what's curious to me is how this map is literally a straight shot, you know? There's literally nothing else on this map except for just up and down. And that, oh my god, that's where we begin. That's where the train is going to be. I hope it's going to stop. I mean, we can already see two enemies on top of the train. Probably two groups, but what's concerning are all of these plus symbols here. I wonder if they're vehicles of their, or if they're helicopters. This might also, this is most likely a helicopter. And yeah, there are like a ton of buildings along the way as well. So I honestly don't know how this is going to go. And well, we basically need to take control of the train before it crosses the border. And that's all that this mission is, to be honest. Strange mission? Very strange, how do I put it, level design from what I can say. But I don't really, at the same time, I don't really think it's going to go well with the way that this game works. I think I'm going to stick to the shotgun instead.
King 6, the Black Widow. Transport Bravo to Objective Echo. Begin insertion when target is in sight. Clear that train of all hostiles.
Roger, King 6. And yeah, this is how we play this mission properly. First time around, I just rode the helicopter all the way to the end. And it just said mission success, despite having not cleared the train of any enemies. But that's just how this mission goes, to be honest. If you make it to the extract, you're golden. And that's literally all there is to it. Can we get the helicopter audio again, please? Why did that stop? I mean, this game is full of bugs, so so essentially what we need to do is we need to jump onto the moving train from here. That's mostly the difficult part in this mission. But at least we'll be moving, so hitting us would be difficult for most, you know, people that are not around us. And this is the part where we jump off into onto the train, essentially. I mean, we still have to jump onto the train, so that in itself is a very pretty difficult task, if you ask me. Oh no, come on. Come on! They're like insertion complete. Bye bye. But in all honesty, the insertion is not complete. At least I have like a measure of cover from here. So this is good. Should be another guy right here. I think there are like a couple of vehicles over there that we need to get rid of. Well, we'll get rid of those vehicles and then go forward. Yeah, oh shit. Not again. Like, you don't really have a ton of maneuverability on this train. And sometimes, the controls in this game also suck, so you can essentially just dive off places without ever meaning to. Like, what just happened with me? I didn't mean to dive off there, but I just did nonetheless. That's also a pretty quick reload for this gun in Delta Force 1. The reload wasn't as quick, so...
Black Widow King.
Yeah, Black Widow was saying Black Widow King 6, the bogey has been... Like, essentially, the train has been taken care of, so we're free to essentially just go as we please, go where we want to. Now, the reason I'm staying in this middle car is because it's going to be difficult for most enemies to get me, unless it's like a freak shot of sorts. So, I do believe this is like the safest car to be in. And the rest of the enemies, well, you can take them out or you can not do that, it's totally your call. We just needed to clear the train of enemies, and that's what we did. The first time around that I played this level, I just stayed on the helicopter, and the helicopter took me all the way to the extract. Yeah, that was funny. That was funny. Oh, right, I completely forgot that I did not bring any laws for the enemy helicopter that is about to attack us. And here it comes. Here's to hoping that it does not pierce us with its infinite amount of rounds and all its infinite knowledge. Last time around I just stayed in the middle, and I hope that will suffice this time around as well. It's gonna start shooting through the carriages. I just hope I'm not in the receiving end of any bullets. You can see the wheels of the train as well. But yeah, given the fact that this train actually contains stuff that the enemy wants, they can't exactly go ahead and blow it up either. So, as of the time that I'm currently playing this mission, I have come to realize the fact that this mission was actually supposed to be played before I ever played, well, quick stop. I'm just gonna move a bit to the center so the helo can't get to me. It's gonna leave me alone after a bit, so no worries there. It's just gonna hover over there in the back and just go away after a bit. There are two trucks to my left, and I would like to keep them to my left, to be honest. And there's the helo that we need to be careful of. And need to be careful of that helo, to be honest, and that's really my only concern. I think as long as I'm on this side, the helo can't get to me. I sort of made a blunder by not like bringing the law around this time. But I suppose this also works for the most part. Yeah, I think the helo is falling behind. It has fallen behind at this point in time. I feel like this is a far better side to be on. In case we get to see an enemies that might want to kill us. The helo has fallen far behind now, at this point in time, so I think we're fine. Just this section up ahead has like a bunch of enemies. I'm only killing them because this is a rail shooter. There are like a bunch of them, a few snipers that we need to be careful of as well. Yeah, proceeding cautiously. And we have successfully extracted for the most part, from the looks of it. It's just one more checkpoint remaining before we extract. Before we actually went ahead and extract, I decided to get rid of a few more enemies. You know, for the greater good. And that's what that was. Is that our helo? Is that the enemy helo? I have no idea. Yeah, I don't think I see our helo, like the enemy helo. I think that's our helo. Right there, yes. So we just need to stay here, and yeah, we can extract the train.
Stand by for pickup.
Is the train gonna stop though? It does come to a stop. Nice. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna quickly run through these carriages, and I'm gonna make an attempt to run to my train. Sorry, to my chopper, and then extract. So I suppose the train is safe, although I don't know how they're gonna actually make it so that... Oh, the chopper is still following us. Oh, damn. No, I think the chopper just stands there. It doesn't really have an issue. Alright, that's our cue to get out. Bye-bye! And that was that for Mission Whistle Stop. At the time that I've completed it, you guys can already see that I've finished Mission Hourglass, but I'll be releasing it afterwards, after Mission Whistle Stop, because after playing this mission, I sort of realized that Mission Hourglass was the end of Operation Common Resolve. So, yeah, for you guys, the next video will be Mission Hourglass, even though in the introduction of Mission Hourglass, I say otherwise, because I hadn't completed Mission Whistle Stop at that time. Hourglass just felt like a higher priority mission back then, so we went for that. And I honestly don't know what happened to Slieght of Hand. Maybe there was some way of completing the mission successfully that I did not know of, but yeah, it's like if you destroy any of the cars, it's like sort of it just tells you that the mission has been aborted, and even if you extract, you essentially end up failing the mission too. Not that you can extract, because your Black Widow isn't there to help you with your extraction, and instead there are three entire helicopters that come to just, you know, ruin your day. So I honestly don't know what happened with that. Maybe I'll look up a guide and try to understand what happened. But as for today, that was Mission Whistle Stop. The next time we come back for you guys, it'll be Mission Hourglass. And yeah, as for after Mission Hourglass, we'll be beginning with Operation Global Enforcement. So that, I think, takes place in another African country. Yeah, I don't know which African country it is, though. It looks like it's somewhere in Africa, but I don't know which country. Maybe Chad? I don't know, to be honest. But anyway, it's definitely not Egypt, because I think Egypt is somewhere over here. Then again, I could be wrong, of course. So yeah, thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. Oh yeah, it is Chad. Uranium mining operations, Chad. So until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.